Hello, hello, and welcome to today's class. I'm Ashwini, an artist and a graphic designer from India. Today we are going to paint a beautiful meadow, and I'm sure you guys are gonna love it. So let's see what are the materials we need for it. So these are the materials we'll be using for that. This is Cinerous Blue from the brand Cinelier Watercolors. I absolutely love Cinelier Watercolors. That's the most favorite brand of mine. And next I'll be using the colors from this White Knight's brand. This is another favorite of mine. From that I'll be using green, indigo, may green and carmine. And also I'll always keep this white gouache from the brand Brostro as well. If in case I need somewhere, I'll use that. And these are the brushes I mostly use. So these are from the brands Artisan's Art, and one is from Princeton Neptune series, size number 6, and another one is Brostro mop brush. I'm using here is my most favorite book. It's from the brand Aish Paper. It's 270 GSM 100% cotton watercolor book. So I'll be using this book for this painting, and this is a painting I did last time. Now let's tape down the paper and let's just paint. As for the sketch, we'll be having a horizon line only. So first we'll paint the sky using wet on wet technique. I hope you all know what is wet on wet technique, and if you don't know, it's like we'll apply water first and we'll add wet paint to the wet surface. That's it. So let's apply a clean coat of water there. Now I have loaded my brush with Cinerous Blue, and I'll be applying it to the sky region, leaving white areas to indicate clouds. That's it. Now before it dries off, let's add the foliage part using green. Create a depth to it. I'm using indigo for that. Now Now let's wait for it to completely dry. Yep, it has completely dried. Let's apply water to the bottom region. Now let's apply May green or any other light green you have. Thalo light green is also fine. Any light green. If you don't have a light green, you just apply lemon yellow to the green which you have. And now I have loaded my brush with carmine. And I am just dropping it to the bottom region and also to the area where we applied May green. Do observe carefully. Now let's add a dark green to the upper part of the bottom region. If you have, you may use sap green. I'm adding this to create a depth or variation to the grasses. Paper has dried, so I am applying a little water to the bottom region. I'm not completely covering it, I'm just applying it around the flowers. Now I'm applying May green. You can apply a lighter green, whichever you have. Now let's apply darker green to few areas there. I want to create depth to it. Now I am using a much darker version of the green. I have added a little bit of indigo to the green to make it this dark. Let's add few lines and grasses there, yeah, like that. So here I have used indigo to add the birds. You can use paints gray or black to add the birds there. Actually, I was supposed to use white gouache and add this white dots here, but I have used Posca markers. It's the easier way, right? So I have used Posca markers to add white dots. You can use white gel pen or white watercolor or white gouache to add this white dots. And that's it. Now once it dries off completely, remove the masking tape and just see a beautiful painting. Wow, just look at that finished painting. I absolutely loved it and I hope you also enjoyed this process. Do give it a try, and if you are sharing it in social media, do tag me. My Instagram ID is @septemberflower. Yeah, that's it, and thank you for watching this video. I'll be coming with another tutorial on next Sunday. See you soon. Thank you. Have a nice day.